श्रीकृष्ण गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः We have come up to 43rd sutra. Deshataha kalataha vastutaha paricheda rahita advitiya atmanubhava siddhi samyak bhuyat. May we attain the perfect experience of being which is beyond the limitations of time, space and object. In short, we have to now start living no more as the body, but we live through the body. No more as the mind, but we live through the mind. So when we start living through the body, then the worldly possessions will not be an issue. When we start living through the mind, the relations will not be an issue. When possessions and relations are unloaded, what remains is Paramatma. May this happen to us. Up to here we have seen. Now, purvapara paramarsham paramarsha antarena sahasotpadyamanasya krodhadivritti visheshasya hetoho chitta samskarasya vivekajanyayam kshantyadi vasanayam drudhayam satyam vinashat bahya nimittabhavena krodha adi anutpatihi samyak bhuyat. What is this language you are talking? Is it French? German? We are supposed to be Indian, knowing Hindi very well. Purva apara paramarsha antarena, without thinking the consequences. If we do this, this is not good. Is it necessary to do? Purva apara paramarsha. Paramarsha means thinking about, taking into account. If I jump into this, there are crocodiles. Will I eat the crocodile or crocodile will eat me? Paramarsha is doing the things with proper understanding. Many a time the things are done without any understanding, mechanically. So, before doing purva, apara, after doing. So, purva apara paramarsha antarena sahasa utpadyamanasya. Sahasa means by default. What is happening by default in us? Krodhadi vritti. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya. These things have become our second nature. There is no need also, and yet these things really create a big turmoil in our life. Then krodhadi vritti visheshasya. Therefore, when Arjuna asks a question to Bhagavan Sri Krishna, why people do wrong things? Why do they go the wrong way? They don't want, and yet as if somebody is compelling them to go the wrong way. Anichannapi. There Bhagavan gives the same answer. Kama esha krodha esha rajo guna samudbhavaha maha asanaha maha papma viddhenam iha vairinam. Because when one comes under the sway, attack of kama, krodha, etc., then one is completely lost of all wisdom and discrimination. In the fifth chapter, Bhagavan says, Shaknoti haivayas sodhum prak sharira vivokshanat kama krodhod bhavam vegam sa muktasya sukhi naraha. He who is able to stand the attack of desire and anger, meaning desire and anger may come, but we don't fall prey to that. ही हु इज एबल टू स्टैंड शक्नोति है वय सोडुम, ही हु कैन सह सकता है सोडुम सहना, ही हु कैन स्टैंड वॉट इज दैट काम क्रोधोद्भवम वेगम, इट इज ए काइंड ऑफ अटैक दैट कम्स. लोभ ग्रीड इज नॉट लाइक एन अटैक, ग्रीड इज लाइक द कफ. इन रामचरित मानस द कफ इज इंडिकेटेड विद द ग्रीड. सो यू थ्रो इट आउट अगेन इट कम्स अप, यू थ्रो इट आउट अगेन इट कम्स अप. बट काम क्रोध दे कम एज अटैक. देयरफोर सहसा उत्पद्य मानस्य एंड दिस हैज टू बी कंट्रोल्ड. Whenever we justify anything, we don't want to get rid of that. Suppose we justify anger. See, unless you become angry, the people don't work. Means what? You are justifying anger, so you don't want to get rid of the anger. For you, work is more important than your peace of mind. See, friends. Therefore, one simple rule. He who becomes disturbed, angry, frustrated because of others, he is the fool of the highest order. Why should we become angry because of something or somebody? No. If we cannot tolerate, close your eyes and walk away. That's it. There is no point in reacting to anything in life. So, krodhadi vritti visheshasya. In Bhagavat Mahapuran, the different techniques are told. Because Bhagavad Katha is normally heard by the Sethji and business people. So maybe something will help them. So in their language, Bhagavad tells. To conquer the desire, invoke anger. To conquer the anger, invoke greed. Example. You are a salesperson in a shop, cloth shop, and then the Maharanis come, and what they can think about the cloth and the design, Brahmaji has never thought about. How do you know, Swamiji? Because I am a victim of that once upon a time. One lady came from USA in Delhi, and she said, Swamiji, I have to buy sarees. You, I said, come on, why should I come with you? You go and buy. He said, no, 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 you take us to the best shop, you know. So, where is the choice? I am a choiceless existence. Whether I want or not, somebody comes and put in sari, Swamiji, khao. Are, a dabba hai kya? That is why I don't allow anybody to give me anything. The other day, very recently happened, Pune. I went for only few hours for the, you know, marriage. After that, no, I can select what food I want. No, 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 you sit down here. So they will listen to you. And then they decide what I should eat. So when they gave something rubbish, I finished. And then I saw other plates, all that I wanted was there. That is the reason I don't allow anybody, no, keep away. And they have got their own whims and fancy, you know. Swamiji doesn't like this, right? I said I don't like it because it was useless. See, friends. So, you go to a shop for buying the clothes. And I was taking nice Coca-Cola those days, maybe about 30 years before story I am telling you. And a very nice AC hall and so many things. This lady was seeing this, seeing that, and finally she came to me. Swamiji, you explain, he doesn't understand. Now, what can I explain about sari? Can you imagine how people use us? Then she told me, Swamiji, this design, this texture, this color, and this border in four different saris, a combination of that you show her. So, that salesperson looked at me. I said, now I'll tell you Upadesha Bhagavata. If you want to earn money, you cannot become angry with her. If there is lobha, you cannot become angry. So to conquer the greed, you have to conquer the anger, you have to invoke the greed. Contrary to that, you go to a Bengali shop, they will take your interview. They will not show you anything. What for you want? What is your budget? Is it an old lady or a young lady? What is the. Are you show? Therefore, in a Bengali shop, you go to buy a sari, you will not buy even a handkerchief and come back. And you go to a Sindhi shop to buy a handkerchief, you will buy a suit and come back. Therefore, these kama, krodha, lobha, they have to be conquered. There is no way out. So, krodhadi visheshasya hetoho, chitta samskarasya, viveka janyayam, kshantyadi, vasanayam, drudhayam, satyam. So, we have to invoke the contrary. So, what is the contrary? Is kshantyadi. So, if there is anger, keep cool. If there is desire, do not feel that fulfillment of desire is equal to fulfillment in life. How many things we have bought so far? Have we used all of them? Viveka janyayam, by discrimination alone, the desire and anger can be conquered. Then, this one kind of thing, drudhayam satyam. So they have to be firmly established. Therefore, when we are functioning in the world, where is our attention? This is the principle. If our attention is on the world, we'll like to improve the world. So the husband wants to improve wife. In Sanskrit, it is called as ashakyanushthan. There is one species called as wife which cannot be improved. Then what is to be done? That is why men are called as sahan shakti. The wife is shakti. Husbands are sahan shakti. There is no choice. See? Therefore, just tolerate. But if we start reacting, our attention is lost from the mind. So the world has always been like this. There is nothing new. Be indifferent. Valuable thing is our peace of mind. And once we take this as spiritual practice, that for any reason our peace of mind should not be compromised. And when you feel that you have crossed your limit of endurance, go to bathroom straight away. Yad gatvan anivartante. And sit there for half an hour. That time don't do any physical work, you'll start breaking the things. Therefore, viveka janyayam, drudhayam satyam, vinashat, then all these negativities, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya, will be destroyed because bahya nimitta abhavena. Now, because your attention is on the quality of your mind, then bahya nimitta abhavena. You are not concerned about what is happening outside. This is how we don't understand how we are fooled by ourselves. There was one Mahatma in Vrindavan. He was very cool, quiet. Nobody has ever seen him becoming angry in his life. Nobody has seen him becoming angry. Never. So one Amma came and told, Maharaj, I want to tell you something. So he looked at her. So what do you want to do? You know that man who comes for satsang, he is constantly looking at me. You tell him to get away. He is a very bad person. Constantly looking at me. So Maharaj, cool. How do you know, beta, that he is constantly looking at you unless you look at him constantly? See? Don't blame the world. Focus your attention on yourself. This is what happens many times. I think so and so is not happy with me, doesn't talk to me. You see, your own fun, nobody is responsible for that. See, one girl in a college after my lecture was over, question and answer, she said, Swamiji, I don't like you playing with your beard. I say, it's your problem, not my problem. Don't try to solve anybody's problem in life. Then create problem for them and keep them busy. Don't try to solve anybody's problems. Know what they will think. Let them think. Why you think on their behalf? See, friends, we unnecessarily get involved in this world. And when we are told, will you please shut up, then we get hurt. See, I was telling only for his good, but he doesn't understand. You also don't understand. See, my friends, therefore, important thing is, bahya nimitta abhavena, don't allow external world to influence on you. Then what will happen? Krodhadi anutpattihi samyak bhuyat. Then all the aberrations of the mind will stop. There are two types of thoughts. One thoughts are called as vichara. In English, we don't have that differentiation. One kind of thoughts are called vichara and other type of thoughts are called as vikara. Vikara are the abnormalities of the mind, which we want to get rid of. See, if our hand is swollen, so do you say, see, I have become healthy? No, man, it's abscess. Oh, it's abscess. I thought I have become healthy. So we remove that because it's unhealthy condition. In the same manner, kama, krodha, lobha, etc. Why we want to remove it? Because it is unhealthy condition of the mind. So unhealthy condition of the mind is called as vikar. And vichara is what? These are cultivated thought patterns based on the wisdom gathered from the scriptures and the instructions followed from the teacher. They are called as vichara. Kama, krodha, lobha, they are cancelling each other. They are haphazard. But vichara is unidirectional. Like, you know, the example I gave you, the crease. The crease adds a beauty to the cloth. But the wrinkles make the cloth look ugly. So the wrinkles are like the kama, krodha, etc. And the crease is like contemplation, inquiry. See the difference. And both of them are thoughts. Anger is a thought. Chanting Lord's name is also a thought. See? Desiring something is a thought. Vairagya is also a thought. Getting disturbed is also a thought. And seeking silence is also a thought. But the difference between the two, one is a healthy condition, other is unhealthy condition. Therefore, krodhai anutpatti samyak bhuyat. And this we can learn if we analyze our own experiences. See, many, many, many years before, there was a friend of mine. He had the pulp factory. They were having a fruit factory. One of the product was mango pulp and the second was the pineapple slices. And he had his customer from Switzerland. He's a good friend of mine, very good business. So a dinner was organized, I was also called. After food was over, we were sitting and then he said, Mr. So-and-so, you wanted to know something about India, Gita, etc. Here is our expert, he will talk on Gita. Those days I was young, finding a chance to show to the world how much knowledge I have. And the blood was boiling always, never cool. So I started Gita, Gita, Gita. Anything I will say after 2-3 sentences, he will say, excuse me, Swamiji. See, the same thing is said in your Bible. Once I heard, second time I heard, third time I heard, fourth time I blasted out. I said, how you dare compare Gita with Bible? Useless. See, Gita is directly told by Bhagavan Krishna. It is written by some useless fellows. And I started becoming so angry and gave so many quotations from here and there and proved how Bible is useless. Now his customer gone. He has used me to get the customer. And after that, when I came home, then I was reflecting on that. I said, what I have achieved today? Was it necessary for me to lose my cool? What I have achieved? I only destroyed my peace of mind. Am I here to protect Gita or Bhagavan is protecting me? See, that day onwards, no reason to justify your anger. When you learn, then it happens. But when we become angry every now and then this is another thing I learned from children. How the children evaluate the parents. In Bombay, I was with one of my friend and we went somewhere. So while going, I don't like peace in the house. House should be like a Dharma Kshetri, Kuru Kshetri. Then there is a fun in the house. Otherwise it is like a 5-star hotel. What is useless? You know? So before going, they had a child, a very beautiful girl, maybe about 6 years or so. So I told her, I said, hey, your dad is going out. Don't you tell him to bring some chocolate? Oh, yes, I can tell. Papa, please get me a nice chocolate bar, okay? He said, okay, darling. We went out, we came, and I knew he had not purchased. So I went to her. I said, hey, you ask something, go and ask. Then I imagine there will be firework. So she said, Daddy, I told you to get me chocolate. Oh God, beta, I just forgot. She went cool back. My program failed. My software was very hard. Then, but I didn't give up. So I went to that child. I said, hey, your daddy didn't, don't you feel bad? He said, no. Why? If he brings, it is a surprise. I have given 100% discount to my father. That child, 6 years, these are her words. I have given 100% discount to my father. And then we say, children don't respect us. They are observing every small little thing. But we are not living in awareness. And then we are very easy to condemn children. Aajkal ke bachche bigad gaye. Where are you? The whole problem in the world is never created by children. It's the oldies who are creating the problems. See? Therefore, this krodhadi nimitta abhavena, do not allow anything in this world to have freedom to ignite anger in you. That is important. So, vinashar bahya nimitta bhavena krodhadi anutpatti samyak bhuyat. In one of the places, probably Arunachal, somebody met me, our Indian only, Hindu only, and he said, Swamiji, I'll tell you something, don't mind. I said, no, I have no mind. As you don't listen to me, I will not listen to you. Say, talk. He said, you know, these Christian missionaries, when they come, they give the things, and they work. But when you people come, you beg, you ask. Why this is so? I said, because for them, it is the business. See? Use life boy and become beautiful. In the same way. Become Christian and go to heaven. I said, we don't tell the lies. We are doing our sadhana. When you are hungry, you go and ask for food. and you don't get food, that time if you can control your anger, then you are a seeker. So Swamiji, then you don't have to have any problem, because every time you are going for a bhiksha, you don't have to ask, they come and give you. So try to be in my shoes, then you will understand. One girl, lady from Delhi, she came with me to Jaipur. Jaipur is a place worthy of eating anything. They will feed you till you die. So after the third day, morning she got up, she came in my room and did namaskar, but this time namaskar was not normal. She held my feet. I said, hey, what is happening to you? Swamiji, please. I said, no, please. I had told you when you came, only one condition. Satsang, you need not come. For food, you have to come. Because you told me, Swamiji, aapka maja badhiya khane ko milta. I said, you come now. She said, Swamiji, please kick me, but I will not come for food. Try to take 3-4 meals a day and survive. And yet I can't become angry with these ammas. So what do? Then I have my own technique. They give so much of food as if I have not taken food for a few hundred years. And initially when I was new in my profession, I didn't know how to handle it. Now when they give, I don't say nothing. I just keep it outside. Take whatever I want. Swamiji, take this one. No, it's not good. Over. You don't have to become angry. You know, when you tell them sincerely, you don't want, they will never listen. It's not good. So, idea is, your mind should be at peace. How important it is. When we are at peace, then only we can think about God. A disturbed person will think about disturbances. A person with a root canal, if he has to sit for meditation, what will be his mudra? What is this? This is the transcendental meditation. Not transcendental. Transcendental meditation. A miserable person can never think of God. Prasanna chetaso yashu buddhi pariyavadishtate. Therefore, friends, work on the mind. And this is only one work. Keep cool. Ashantasya kutasukam. And for that, find out your own techniques. One or two techniques of mine. One technique. There was one girl, now she is married. She was supposed to come with me to Uganda many years before. So her passport was to be done. So when I was talking to her, there was another person. He said, Swamiji, don't worry, I'll get it for her. I said, hey, hang around him, he'll get it for you. Once, twice, thrice, four times she went, and he was just keeping her moving. One day she came, Swamiji, that man is so useless. Every time he calls me but does nothing, 6-7 times I have gone. I don't know what to do. I said, first of all, keep cool. And remember, we are on the spiritual path. Don't forget that. And this is one we have to learn. We have no right on anybody in this world. You will be at peace. No right. Write off your rights right away. Before they perform your rights right now. No right on anybody, on anything in this world. See? Once you write off, you can never become angry. We become angry because we exercise our right. What right we have got? We have no right on our gross body. Our body doesn't listen to us. But we have, but is it not, you know, nothing? If you are a seeker of truth, see, friend, then only the mind will never be a problem for us. So, purvapara, पूर्वापर परामर्श अंतरेण सहसोत्पद्यमानस्य क्रोधादि वृत्ति विशेष से हेतु चित्त संस्कार से विवेक जन्यायाम क्षांत्यादि वासनायाम दृढ़ायाम सत्याम विनाशान बाह्य निमित्त अभावेन क्रोधादि अनुत्पत्ति ही सम्यक भूयात। नाउ दिस इज द थिंग वी हैव टू रिमेम्बर अगेन एंड अगेन इन माइंड। यस्य प्रसादात् अहमेव विष्णु मय्येव सकलं परिकल्पितं च इति आत्मस्वरूपं विजानामि पादारविन्दयोः अचञ्चला भक्तिः निरन्तरं सम्यक् भूयात्। यस्य प्रसादात् इति आत्मस्वरूपं विजानामि। सी फ्रेंड्स, अप टू ए पर्टिकुलर लिमिट आवर एफर्ट्स आर यूजफुल। Efforts take us up to a particular limit. Beyond that, the one who was putting efforts, he becomes an obstacle. So we have to discard that. See? So first put efforts, work hard, but at the end come to know, success is not the result of our actions. This I discovered from a child. He said, Swamiji, you people talk double standard. I said, please explain. He said, when you say something good has happened to us, oh, by God's grace, Bhagwan ki kirpa se ho gaya. And when something bad happens, we are told, it is your prarabdha karma from the last life, therefore you are suffering. Why double standard? I said, you are very intelligent, you have thought properly. Now look here. If we say, whatever bad things we are doing, it is God's creation, then we are descendants of Duryodhana. Then we have to be responsible for our life. At the same time, we should not be arrogant in our life. Arrogance comes. I have done so much, I have done so much. Remember, Paramatma is not the result of any action. We have to drop this. The one who was putting action, efforts, doing meditation, doing the japa, no. Many people have that notion. One lady asked me this question, Swamiji, my guru is no more there and they have given us mantra when we were small. In our village, their Guru Maharaj came. And that time I was a small girl, maybe 10, 12 years. Everybody was given diksha, I was also standing in the line. And what he said, I didn't understand. But then I was told, this is Ramnam mantra. And as a child, you know, he was so weird, jata and all kinds of things. When he came nearer my ear, I was only thinking, okay, and ran away. I didn't know what happened. And then Ram, 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 I have been doing for last so many years, nothing has happened. So what should I do? Meaning, because of my chanting the mantra, something should happen. See, friends, be attentive. We chant Lord's name only to keep the mind occupied. Yame vesha vrunute te na labhyaha tasesha atma vivrunute tanum swam. The Lord chooses to whom to reveal. Not our efforts. Yogam yunjan madashraya asamshayam samagram mam yatha jnasasi tashrunu. In the 7th chapter, Bhagavan says, madashraya, ashray, support is only the Lord. See? So if we are chanting the Lord's name, it is not my efforts, it is His grace. With this extreme awareness, when we do not allow that I factor to be introduced in our life, being alone, the divine manifests. And that manifestation of the divine is called as God's grace. The last touch is His. In 18th chapter, Bhagavan says, Adhishthanam tatha karta karanam cha prutak vidham vividha cha prutak cheshta daivam chaivatra panchamam sharira vang manor bhiyat karma prarabhate naraha nyayam va viparitam va panchaite tasya hetava. These are the five factors which go in the completion of any action through body, mind or speech. Those are adhishthanam, body, tatha karta, the doer, karanam, the instrument, pratak cheshta, the efforts, and daivam chaivatra panchamam, divine grace. It is something like this. I was standing near a tree, mango tree, and children from a school, village school, they were going. I was watching them, very sweet children. One child saw those fruits, so beautiful, but I can't reach here. Simply looked at it, went away. The other people, children were coming, they came and they tried to throw the stone and it fell on their head, he also went away. Then another children came, tried to climb on the tree, could not climb, fell down, but he never gave up. Then again he took the stone but he didn't hit. Then again he collected 5-6 stones, one after another. Again he tried to climb, jump. He didn't give up. Because I was standing there, what will I do? The one who is putting sincere efforts, I went, lifted him up and he plucked the mango. Why I didn't do to the other people, other children? Because they are not put efforts. Efforts we put. But the ultimate stamp is divine grace. This is the biggest obstacle for most of the seekers. They feel that because of our sadhana, things are happening. No, even sadhana is happening because of divine grace. See, friends, adhyatma is not only a logic reason. It is not karma, it is not upasana. Ultimately, sarvadharman parityajya mamekam sharanam raja. When I disappear, he manifests. See? Even for a simple thing like a sleep, unless I disappear, the sleep doesn't begin. Therefore, yasya prasadan, he by whose grace, ahameva Vishnu, mai eva sakalam parikalpitam cha iti atmaswarupam vijanami. So, by the divine grace only we come to recognize ahameva Vishnu. The Vishnu doesn't mean four hands have come out and Shankar Chakra and you have got a scratching below your mukut. That is not the meaning. See, Vishnu means the one who is all pervading. This exercise or practice of all pervasiveness, slowly it expands when we come to inquire, contemplate and try to learn from our experience. All colors and forms are only through the eyes. Now what is the vision? Vision is expression of mind through the eyes. Now are the minds separate from each other? Of course, very good. Now what is the mind? Mind is expression of consciousness in the body. Okay. So, is consciousness separate from each other? No. Therefore, one consciousness alone is expressing through. This is what in the 13th chapter Bhagavan says, Kshetratnyam chapi mam vidhi sarva kshetreshu bharata. Because our attention is on the periphery, we lose the center. Come to the center. Then we come to know If I is there, then my wife is there. If I is there, then my country is there. If I is there, then my friend is there. If I is there, my enemy is there. Therefore, everything is me. But the question is, what is the meaning of this I? Vedaishya sarvai ahameva vidyaha. This I has to be recognized. Who is this I? We are not one inside, we are a crowd. When I say I am old, here the meaning of I is body. When I say I am tall, here the meaning of the word I is the length of the body. When I say I am hungry, here the meaning of I is the pranamaya kosha. When I say I am unhappy, the meaning is mind. When I say I am a self-made man, meaning is Vijnanamaya Kosha. When I say I am a happy-go-lucky, I am Anandamaya Kosha. When I say my son doesn't listen to me, what should I do? I have become a father. So how many of we are inside? One or a crowd? And where there is a crowd, there cannot be peace. So find out all these crowds, which is the real I. And this is what Bhagavan says in 15th chapter. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtaha. I am in the heart of everything and being. Like the man is in the heart of the husband. Man is in the heart of the son. Man is in the heart of the father. That doesn't mean man has entered Viri's father, Gusvandar. No. Without this man, these three fellows cannot exist. In the same manner, ahameva Vishnuho. So this aham has to be correctly recognized. See. There are two ahams, and both of them cannot be destroyed. Therefore, the word aham, a means no. Not like Shoka, Ashoka. Anya, Ananya. A means negation. Ham means Hananam, destruction. Aham means that which cannot be killed, that cannot be destroyed. So there are two Ahams which cannot be destroyed. One is Ahameva Vishnu, Paramatma cannot be destroyed. And second is, Jivatma cannot be destroyed. Can you destroy the husband? No. When the wife has walked away, she has taken the husband in her purse. Shall we say, after divorce, the husband died? Kya gaya? Mar gaya bichara husband. But wo to jinda hai na, wo hai ya, husband mar gaya. Illusions never die because they don't exist. See, friends, if you get this point across, all your miseries will disappear. Nobody dies. But we all become miserable as all these illusory eyes. Just observe this. We are all miserable as mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, in-laws, outlaws, grandchildren, grandfather, grandmother. These are the guys who are miserable, who have no existence. Now, how can you improve the reflection fallen in the water? Vichare ko sardi ho rahi hogi. Nikalo. You cannot. So what is the reflection in the water? Entrance without entry. What is a husband? Husband is the reflection where man enters without entry. He doesn't enter. He only appears. See, friends, the day you get this point clear, Bhagavan ki kirpa, bape di phul kirpa. Then you will catch this point. Every thought originates from somebody. Every thought. When you become husband, immediately the thoughts about a wife will start coming up. And husband is real or man is real? So man is real. Husband is an illusion. And what is an illusion? Which appears, which is useful, but which doesn't exist. Like human, like a husband. Useful. But doesn't exist. One Tamil family in Bombay, I went to their house. And that man has recently come from Japan after taking some course, inventory management. And when I was taking food, so he was telling Swamiji, kindly, maybe she will listen to you, she never listens to me. Please tell her on my behalf, I have learned recently inventory management. Anything which is not used for last 6 months is not required. Remove how many things she has accumulated in the house. She said, Swamiji, please tell my husband, he also doesn't listen to me. Both of them hearing each other. I am just a media in between. Tell him that if I had to throw the things out of the house which are not used for 6 months, I will be throwing him first. He is useless, good for nothing. See, friends, therefore, do not accumulate the things. Who is this miserable? I. The one who is not miserable is Vishnu. See? Therefore, if you study Panchadashi, all your webs will be clean. All possible doubts a human mind can entertain, they are sorted out. See? There are two types of creations. One creation is God's creation, second is our creation. In God's creation, there are no miseries. In our creation, there is nothing but misery. God's creation is these five great elements, the world, our body, our sense organs. Where is the problem? Then, what is our creation? A woman is created by God, woman is not a problem. But out of that woman, a mother is created, a wife is created, a sister is created, a daughter is created. So this daughter, sister, mother, wife, they have nothing but problems. Recognize your place in the divine game, not in your creation. You don't have to do anything first. Only correct your focal length. When we can correct our focal length, things are seen as they should be seen. Now we are seeing what is not to be seen. You all must have seen those three-dimensional pictures which are hidden behind some design. You go and see, you can't see what is there, what is there, what is there. In one place when I saw that, I told that person, he said, my God, how could you see that? I tried it for last so many times, I could never see that. Then he took out a booklet from his drawer. He had about 30-40 pictures like that. He said, show me that. I said, you start writing. He said, don't read the thing. I said, don't worry, I will not cheat you. Then I started taking one by one, tak, 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 tak. In 10 seconds, I finished those 30 pictures. How did you do that? I said, when you stop looking, don't focus on anything. Then seeing is happening, but nothing is seen. Like in your case, hearing is happening, but nothing is heard. You are in meditation. Yes, yes, meditation. The sleep was not enough in the meditation, therefore, after breakfast, now it is better. Do you know what is the reason? Only the training that we have given to our mind. We know only two extremes. One is zero-pointed mind. Second is multi-pointed mind. Either our mind is jumping from one to another, or the mind is straight away collapsing. But in between, the mind is neither sleeping nor entertaining any thoughts. Sa sandhi sadhito yena sa mukta natra samshaya. Bhagavan Shankara says, laya vikshepa yoho sandhu manastatra niramisham. When objects or objectiveness from the mind is removed, then only the objectless awareness remains. See, when you look into the mirror, we hardly see the mirror surface because we are so busy with our various angles. Only few hair, but even then. But there is nothing wrong. We should be positive. See, I told you that one old man, completely bald, went to a very spacious, rich spa, unisex saloon. So the barber there was in a jolly good mood. He said, "Uncle, come. Should I count the hair or cut them?" And he said, "Color them." This is called as positive thinking. I hope sleep has gone. In the bhakti satsanga, there where the kathakar sees that most of them are dozing away, then Siyavar Ramachandra ki jai. It is not your fault. It is a manufacturer's defect. Because we have never trained our mind to remain free without keeping it busy somewhere. Just give it a try. And for that, make absence as an object. That is what I told you. When you listen to silence, first thing that happens, you reject the sounds. When you reject the sounds, ears are not functional. Then you come to the mind. This state is no thought, no sleep state. And this can be maintained 24/7. But we are so preoccupied with the worldly things that we go away from the center to the periphery. It is only because we have given importance to the worldly things and beings. This is how our mind strays away, runs here and there. See, my friends, it is not difficult. It is very simple. Only thing we have to be committed to this. Yasya prasadat ahameva Vishnu. So who is this Vishnu? This mind, which is not conditioned with one body, all pervading. This is what we saw in the morning meditation class. We go beyond the mind and come to the life. Live as life, not as a mind. Life doesn't have gender. Life doesn't have ego. Life doesn't have past. Life doesn't have future. Life is. And that life is also only a manifestation of the divine. सो लाइफ इज मैनिफेस्टेशन अनमैनिफेस्टेशन, व्यक्त अव्यक्त, व्यक्त अव्यक्त, देर इज नो व्यक्ति. द व्यक्ति इन द लाइफ इज बॉर्न व्हेन द माइंड बिकम्स एक्टिवेटेड. सी इफ यू नेक्स्ट टाइम सी एनी रिवर फ्लोइंग स्लोली स्टेडिली, नॉट वेरी शार्प फॉल, and if there is some stone or rock or a tree in the flowing waters, you will see near the base of that particular object there is ebbing of the waters. The water runs in the opposite direction, very little. Exactly the same way, when the life is limited to one particular body, that ebbing is called as the thought formation. Then all the thoughts will be only with reference to that body alone. In deep sleep, when we are not identified with the body, there cannot be any thoughts. See, friends, this is the meaning that yasya prasadat aham eva Vishnu, mai eva sakalam parikalpitam cha, and then on the life, when the mind manifests, then I, you, he, she, it, rich, poor, Indian, non-Indian, Hindu, Muslim, all these things are cropped up. And they are only in the mind, they are not in life. See? So from the matter to sentiency, from sentiency to mind, from mind to life, from life to consciousness. These are the steps. There is no way we cannot bypass anything. Yasya prasadat aham eva Vishnu, mai eva sakalam parikalpitam cha, iti atmaswarupam vijanami. This is the meaning of I. Let me recognize this as the real meaning of I. Our meaning of I is so perverted and it keeps on changing. Before marriage, I was a man. After marriage, I became husband. Then again divorce, again now I am what? I don't know. Neither man nor husband. Then a discarded garbage. Na ghar ka, na ghat ka. Then get married again. So, iti atma swarupam vijanami tasya padar vindayoho achala bhaktihi nirantaram samyak bhuyat. And all this can happen when yasya prasadat, because of whose grace these things happen in me, to that Paramatma, tasya padaravindayoho, on the charana kamala padaravindayoho, achala bhakti me nirantaram bhuyat, me I have total surrender, faith, devotion to that Lord and nothing else. Be attentive, therefore, knowledge and devotion, they are not two. Knowledge, when it is matured, it is called as devotion. Devotion, when it is fructifying, it is called as knowledge. On the path of knowledge, devotion, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, Chaturvidha bhajante mam, जना सुकृतनोर्जुन आर्तो जिज्ञासु अर्थार्थी ज्ञानी च भरतर्षभ. ज्ञानी इज नॉलेज. देन ही सेज उदारा सर्व एव इति, ऑल ऑफ देम आर ग्रेट इन देयर ओन प्लेस, बट ज्ञानी तु आत्मैव मे मतम. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू भगवान, ज्ञानी इज अ रियल डिवोटी. अदर्स आर ओनली हैविंग द एक्रोबेटिक्स आउटसाइड. Because they are mistaking upasana for devotion. Upasana is a means. See, friends, and it is all required also, nothing is wrong. You have a particular dress, you have a particular marks on your face, see, either there is a .com or there is a U-turn, oh, doesn't matter. Or you have different kinds of malas, Rudraksha malas, then your Spatika mala. In Kathmandu, one lady, she got one mala from somewhere, shop, and Swamiji, this is a different type of mala I am seeing, what it is? There was one Tulasi, then one Rudraksha, then one Spatika. What is this? I said, this is called a hybrid mala. I am supposed to reply everything. Hybrid. What is the use? I said, when you have Tulasi, you will get devotion. Then you will have this Spatika, you will get money. When you have got Rudraksha, everything will be cancelled. Then what should I do? I said, you decide now. I have given you the purpose. Only external things do not make a devotee. This is upasana. Upasana means, upa means near, asana means to sit. That which takes us nearer to the Lord. And if we are reached nearer to the Lord, even if we go nearer, in a fish market we get the smell on our body. If we go nearer to the Lord, the fragrance of the divinity will emit out of us. And that is nothing but Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma na shochati na kankshati. Only one way of expression of divinity, you are ever cheerful and happy. That's it. See, friends. May this happen. Vijanami yasya padaravindayo achala bhaktihi nirantaram samyak bhuyat. Therefore, a devotee is the one who not only sees the grace of the Lord in the good events of life, but he also is able to discover the divine grace even in bad events. Because from our standpoint, what is good and bad gets cancelled in his vision. Because he is not seeing at us between the womb and the tomb. He sees us beyond that. And therefore, this utter faith in the Lord is devotion. And all external things that we do, it is upasana. So don't mistake upasana for devotion. On the contrary, the upasakas are very obstinate. They are told their guru that you chant Rama mantra. And if Krishna comes in front, they will look this side. Are what kind of upasana it is? Therefore, upasana is external, devotion is internal. Upasana can be changed, devotion is unchanged. Upasana will have doubts, whether I should do this or that, devotion cannot have any doubt. Upasana will have fear, if I don't do this thing, what will happen? When you are devotion, you are fearless. In union with God. So this is what is Vijanami tasya padaravindayo achala bhakti nirantaram me bhuyat. May I have that devotion, utter devotion, complete surrender at the lotus feet of the Lord. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम